They say to stay relevant, you have to continually innovate. So, are you telling me that there's a new Tylenol out there? What's that about?
Find out today on Medical History Mysteries.
Everyone, welcome to Medical History Mysteries. I'm Pam Maragliano Muniz. With me, as always, Tom Viola. There's a new Tylenol. What is that about?
Well, it's not exactly Tylenol, but it is a new version of acetaminophen. It's going to be in the spotlight. It's going to be heavily advertised. It's a gummy bite, an 80 milligram gummy bite designed for kids. It's called Dr. Kids Children's Pain and Fever. It's going to hit the shelf soon. It's a long time coming because a lot of times we want to try to avoid liquid forms, liquid dosage forms. They're messy, they're inconvenient. A gummy is easy. Pop it in your mouth and it's all good. But And I'm sure you know this, Pam, because we're kind of the same age, although you're a lot younger than me. We remember the days when we realized that making medicine look like candy is not a good idea, right? I still see this sometimes. People will do promotions and they'll put M&Ms, right, or something like that, or candy in prescription bottles that they got from the pharmacy. And it's like, oh, it's a bad message to send to kids that medicine can be candy. And yet, here we are creating a gummy that contains acetaminophen, 80 milligrams, notwithstanding, right? That a kid may identify as candy, right? Now, why is that a problem? Okay, because acetaminophen overdoses are a thing. About 50,000 people a year are sent to the hospital with acetaminophen overdoses. It's the leading cause of liver failure in the US. And so I worry because I don't want acetaminophen to be looked at as this candy that's this safe drug that can be used, almost without caution. Acetaminophen can be a dangerous drug. It doesn't take much. 3 grams to 4 grams for an adult, less for kids, can easily cause, liver toxicity. And so I wanted to make sure that everyone who's paying attention now listens, because if a kid's chewing these gummies, if a parent's giving their kid these gummies, they may not even know how much acetaminophen is in each one or how many their child took if child looks at it as candy. And acetaminophen is everywhere. So, NyQuil, DayQuil, Tylenol Cold and Sinus, Excedrin, acetaminophen's in almost everything. And so it's very easy to exceed the maximum recommended daily dose of acetaminophen, especially in kids, and not even know it.
What's the upper limit for acetaminophen in children?
So when possible, we like to dose acetaminophen based on the child's weight. The typical dose is 10 to 15 milligrams per kilogram per dose. We don't like to exceed, if we give it every 4 to 6 hours, which is what's recommended for acetaminophen, we don't like to exceed more than 5 doses or roughly 2.6 grams in 24 hours. Now, sometimes you don't know the weight, so it's important to make sure you've got the child's accurate weight and make sure you convert it to kilograms to make that calculation.
So I'm going to date myself. One of my favorite commercials of all time is a commercial that I watched as a kid. So you guys should Google it. It's like the best commercial ever. It's called We're Not Candy. And it's like the cutest song. And it's these little pills dancing around saying that they're not candy. And even though they look so fine and dandy, and they come in handy, but they're not candy.
Very well done. You remember the lines. I remember the commercial, but I remember the dancing pills, but I don't remember the actual lines. Well done. I give you a lot of credit for that.
Oh,
That's awesome.
I could go on. I know this like by heart. It's just something that's like ingrained in my memory. Okay, so that's what we need to worry about for Tylenol with kids. Google the commercial. It's awesome. There's a new Tylenol out there though, right? That's not even Tylenol. What is that?
Yeah, be careful, okay? Because there are things that are labeled Tylenol that aren't, and there are things that are not labeled Tylenol that are. How about that? So, for example, there's a liquid out there, a roll-on liquid called Tylenol Precise, okay? And you can still find it, it's out there. But Tylenol Precise, this roll-on for musculoskeletal pain, doesn't have any acetaminophen at all. It's basically lidocaine and menthol. And you might think it's Tylenol because it says Tylenol Precise, and you might even worry, ooh, I roll this on, will I, and then take Tylenol orally, will I overdose? Again, you know, read the ingredients to make sure. But the other example would be Advil Dual Action and Motrin Dual Action that both contain ibuprofen and acetaminophen. So again, but the brand name Advil Dual Action and Motrin Dual Action, you may not even realize that the dual action part means that it also contains acetaminophen. And so again, these are reasons why you might end up inadvertently overdosing on acetaminophen because you don't know those tablets contain acetaminophen. So for example, each one of those tablets contains 125 milligrams of ibuprofen and 250 milligrams of acetaminophen in a 1-to-2 ratio. So you've got to be aware of all of the different sources of acetaminophen. It's especially important for us in dentistry because we like to prescribe acetaminophen. We're always prescribing ibuprofen and acetaminophen or opioids with acetaminophen. So we've got to be very careful that we stick to the maximum daily doses. Now, we talked about it for kids. For adults, we say we want to try to limit the dose to no more than 3 to 4 grams or 3,000 to 4,000 milligrams a day. But someone with a compromised liver, we would probably try to limit them to, you know, 2 to 3 grams a day. And even then, that's still pretty high.
So friends, what's the moral of the story here? It sounds to me like you should read the packaging and also do your math and make sure you're not ODing or potentially giving too many gummies to a child when it comes to medication.
Take a complete and accurate medical history for every patient, know exactly what they're consuming and how much they're consuming, and that way you'll be able to make good choices and good decisions when you're dosing acetaminophen for your patient to treat dental pain and so on.
All right. Well, you heard it here. For medical history mysteries, I'm Pam Maragliano Muniz. We messed that one up, but that's fine. We'll see you next week.
Take care, everybody. Thank you.